Joe here in the garage. Today we're doing winter maintenance. We're gonna work on my derelict trailer. Put a new deck on it. New trailer jack, this one's all bent and floppy. A motorcycle cradle to help carry them. Not necessary, but I'm going to. I'm gonna stain the wood before I put it on. I'm gonna show you how to replace the wood. Replace the jack, figure out a way to mount this sucker. So hold on there and watch me stain some wood, and then we'll get around the rest of it. First, gotta move that crap out of the way. Setting up for these YouTube videos. It's an annoyance. It took me 30 minutes just to set this up. I gotta move it all. Paint liners, home desk spot, paint kit, cheap shit. I'm using Thompson water seal with stain already in it. Shake well before using. I think they make an invention for this. Okay. There you have it. I'm going to flip them over, rinse and repeat, and we'll come back tomorrow. All right. Good morning. Next day. As you can see, the boards are all done, stacked up over there. Now we're going to take the old ones out. All these store brand trailers are basically the same. This strip is all that pretty much holds them down. A couple spot welds in a few spots. This one has some nails in there. We'll have to probably cut them. But cut that metal strip out and do what we do. Thank you. that corner pop loose, do it the other two.
Center.
afford that.
Thank you.
before I put this all back together, I just wanted to see real quick. There's a cross member every 2 feet. You can reinstall this three different ways. Put it right back the exact same way it was with just the bar weld across the top. You don't have to put any kind of bolts in between because they ain't gonna come back out. You can drill every cross rail and either put a nut and bolt, carriage bolt, and bolt everything down, not worry about re-welding, or self-tapping screws straight through the wood, straight into the metal, and attach every cross member that way. But whatever you like. Okay, so what we're gonna do, like I said, we're gonna weld together. You are trying to weld wood and metal together in the same place. So don't put too much heat in at once. Weld a little bit, come back to it. Weld a little bit, come back to it. If it starts to get too hot, get your bottle of water and douse it, it'll be fine. This wood's wet. The old wood was all dry, so it was easy to catch fire. This won't catch fire very easy. Safety squints. No, it ain't pretty. It ain't the space shuttle either. It's a fucking trailer. But I'm gonna do the rest of this. I'm gonna come back. All right, another thing we need to work on is replace this latch pin. It got broke a long time ago. Just a simple little spring-loaded pin. So we're gonna weld one together out of a couple of bolts. Take the two of these, weld them together, make a little T-handle. That together for a little bit. Get it tacked up. good enough. It ain't going nowhere. Oh, so let's clean it off and cool it off. All the water. Here again, it's a trailer, not a space shuttle. It doesn't have to be beautiful. This has to be functional. I'll bet you that's hot. My rag's melting to it. Alright, well, it can sit there and cool. It ain't hurt nothing. Now we need to drill a hole for the spring. Needs to be roughly 2 3/8 on the end. Oh, I know what I need. Let's measure. About right here. I was looking the wrong one. There. I guess where you can see what I'm doing. Broke a frickin' drill bit. That sucks. Probably ain't gonna get that one back out of there, are we? I don't think I got that hole in the wrong spot anyhow. Look at that again. that's still too hot? No. Not as bad. Pause for this commercial break. I had to grind a little nub off that weld. Wouldn't go in far enough. So, let's try this again with a new hole that I'm sure I'll break another bit off into. Let's just jump straight up to eighth inch where we need to be. Make sure it's big enough. If I could grab my pen. And yes, it's big enough now. So now, come over here. And just y'all, things feel a little better. Something to pull the spring back out of our way a little bit. And there. And that should work. Okay. just kind of pull the extra pin material out of the cutter pin out of the way. Need to bend that a little bit more. There we go. That's more. Bolt that one around that direction. And there we go. Hold it unlocked. And locked. Voila. Like that. All right, let's install a jack. Nothing to see here, OSHA. It is a very basic kit. Pretty much the same ones already on there. It will come in the box. Unassembled, well, half assembled. Gotta put the wheel on it. Just as easy taking one off and putting one back on. Put it back on about the same place we had it. Brackets, nuts, bolts, instructions. Don't need none of that. Instructions. Who they think we are. Somebody knows what we're doing. That's who we are. In case you're watching, this is electric hardware. It is from China, y'all. You know how I know that? Because it's different. This where we want to be. Hear something pop. Safety third. Now this one has a lock nut. You don't want to tighten it too much because then it won't never turn. Oh, how necessary that is. Oh, look, it's bigger. There we go. It's a 19. See how prepared I am. There you go. That's about all I need. Put the handle on. What size is that one? Back to 17 again. Okay. It's got a captive bolt, or no, it don't. It requires a wrench. Ain't that nifty? And of course, this teeny tiny. It's a 12. Give me that. This thing ain't a pain in the ass to get started. There we go. Switch back to our 17. 12 on the stud. On the stud, I know that. All of it. And I'll try to fight to get your wrench back out of there. Didn't put the wrench on a flat spot. Oh well, we did put the wrench on a flat spot. It shoved it out.
Wedging it in there.
See, yeah. You gotta be able to hold it.
Yeah.
Too tight. Thank you. All right, let's assemble the Pittsburgh motorcycle stand. Model 61670. Let's open this together. Let's see what comes in the box. Here's our motorcycle stand, shrink wrapped to cardboard. Looks like it's mostly assembled. Bolts, a couple of pins, I don't see how they got the plastic bag on that beforehand, so we gotta cut it off. Instructions, who knows those? They're for losers. Upright. Piece of cardboard. And the body plate. I'd say this is probably easy. I don't think I need no instructions. Do you?
No.
Couldn't be. All right. We need a couple of wrenches and sockets. I'm sure they're metric. Let's go find out. See, I wasn't prepared because I wanted you to see me open it. Well, I already know they're 17 millimeter. Get this out of our way. We don't need a pitcher either. We're good. So we're gonna say this probably goes here. Yeah, that's how that works. Yep, yep, yep. See, we don't need no stinking instructions. We're real men. Men don't need instructions. That one goes through there. Not in the washer. No, I mean, come on, common sense got to tell you. The bolt needs to go in from this direction because your tire's here. You don't want your tire getting popped by a bolt sticking out. Well, now, what the? Oh, well. This is those funky ones where bolt size is different than the nut. Oh, we still have sorry, that's his problem. 14, yes. How much torque until it starts to bend, and then back off just a hair. That's gonna go here with one of your fancy pins. Whatever made them want to push the pin all the way on there like that is beyond me. Pin doesn't have to be all the way shoved on there, just that far. And the rods and pins are always adjustable. So you have multiple holes to move this forward and backward. Another one for the back. Here again, pins are shoved on there so far. Wow, that was neat. Uh-oh, now we did it. Oh no, it's gone forever. Well, let's get another pin out. We'll find that later, it's hiding behind a workbench. Don't think it rightly matters. I'd say it goes on that way. Nope, working. And then another washer and another pin that I'll have to go get. I got one out of there, we'll just put a cotter pin in it instead, works just fine. Harbor Freight to the rescue. And there you have it, it's assembled, that's done. Then we can put it on the trailer. Some mounting holes to bolt it down to the trailer. And you're good to go. That right there is how it would look installed. Just like I said, put you a couple bolts in there to lock it down. Quite honestly, I don't think you'd have to lock it down. Make it a little bit more functional. We got one other treat I forgot that I had. Some bearing buddies or bearing protectors. Got grease zerks in them. And we don't have to pull this shit apart to grease it no more. So give me a little bit and we'll set up. Alright, so here we go. These are pretty easy, straightforward. Can you see? Yeah, you can see. Now you see a little bit better. Cap. Take the old cap off. You're probably gonna dent it, so don't fret it, because you're gonna change it anyway. There we go. Cap off. Now, just start it with a hammer. Get as straight as you can, but get started. Now, so you don't damage it, which I'm using a plastic hammer anyway. Get you a block of wood. And just drive her home. So don't move. Simple install. There's a little grease spitting in here. So now, to grease these, you just hit the grease circ and fill it up until it comes out. Well, if you can see it, there's a little hole there. I'll show you this one. It's on top. Until the grease starts to come out of that little hole. And it's full. Then comes a little dust cap to put on there to keep dirt out. So that's it. Later. Okay, so there you have it. One Maintenance trailer. New jack, new decking, a little chalk for your mower pickle, some bearing buddies that we had to make a pin for the gate. There you go. Hope you enjoy. Till next time.